उनके नर्सिंग होम के ऊपर ना हो। बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया।
थैंक यू श्री हसनाई मसौरी।
Honorable Chairperson, see, I'm grateful for giving me an opportunity to speak on this important bill. I would first speak in context of Jammu and Kashmir and then try to dilate on different aspects of the bill. Sir, in section 1-2, the act extends to whole of India. Sir, Jammu Kashmir enjoys a special status in the constitutional scheme. In case of Jammu and Kashmir, we have just two lists, concurrent list and union list. We don't have a state list. Under the arrangement, constitutional arrangement arrived at between the central government and the state government way back in 1952, the state government, Jammu and Kashmir, enjoys all the residue powers, whatever is not included in central union list or in concurrent list, that belongs to the Jammu and Kashmir. So where do we trace the power or the authority to enact this law? I believe that we draw it from entry 25 red, concurrent list read with entry 66 union list. And both the entries, the entry 25 of concurrent list owes its origin to 42nd amendment. See, earlier education was dealt with by entry 11 of the state list. By 42nd amendment, this was taken away and this was transposed to the concurrent list. Entry 25 was recast and entry 25 after this 42nd amendment now reads education, including technical education, medical education and universities, subject to the provisions of entries 63, 64, 65 and 66 of the list. So I believe that you get this power from entry 66 concurrent list, but 42nd amendment was never extended to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Entry 25 is not applicable, 25 concurrent list is not applicable in case of Jammu and Kashmir once 42nd amendment was not extended to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So in case of state of Jammu and Kashmir, we don't have entry 25 that gives this power to annex this law or provide for NEET. And government cannot fall back on, you cannot fall back on entry 25 in case of Jammu and Kashmir. That, so this act cannot be extended to the, may extend to the whole of India except state of Jammu and Kashmir. Then it is for the state of Jammu and Kashmir. It may allow its extension to the state of Jammu and Kashmir or not. This is one. It may be, Honorable Minister may just take a second look at the, this provision, that is 1-2-1. Second is now coming to the provisions of the Act. Mr. Tiwari earlier. Mr. Tiwari earlier said that you throw the baby with the bathwater, and if we go one, we use one more adage, that is, you chop off the head to get rid of the high headache. This is the story about changing MCI, elected body, into now the new entity, that is National Medical Council. See, first casualty is the autonomy, the independence of a body. It is no more elected. I will sound repetitive because everybody has dilated on this aspect of it. It is not now no more an elected body representing the experts in the field. It is again the same story that we have been hearing for last 1 month. It is same that this is now government appointed committee. See, the objectives are laudable: medical education system that ensures availability of adequate and high quality medical professionals. Who can say no? But does bill achieve that? Is there any significant, see, any kind of mechanism shown, included in the bill to achieve that object, to encourage medical professionals to adopt latest medical research? We don't find any mention about it, any kind of elaborate mechanism to achieve this object. And to contribute to the research, don't find any mention. Now, let us go to the main provisions of the Act. Sir, chairperson is an appointee of the government. I mean, the search committee is an eyewash to be headed by the cabinet secretary. And autonomous boards are just autonomous in the name. The way the whoever is to head the advisory boards, all appointees of the government, or directly or indirectly their representatives who can control it. Now please go to section 9.4. The general superintendent's direction and control of the administration of the commission shall vest in the chairperson again an appointee of the central government. There's a big departure from the earlier method, that is earlier mode and method of constituting MCI. That was purely a...
Please conclude.
See, the commission shall specify by regulation the manner of conduct of common counseling. Then again, neat. See, unless and until you provide a level play field. See, our 60% of our population are more than that lives in the rural India. See, whoever is selected in this neat is mostly from urban areas who are exposed to, as earlier one of the honorable members said, CBSC. They don't have that, you know, that background. So more and more candidates in need come from the urban areas. Unless you provide, either you provide some kind of a program, you know, a program before they appear in need in rural areas, so that candidates become competent to appear in the need. You provide some kind of bridge courses for them.
Please conclude this point as been already covered by other members.
Who are marginalized, unattended sections of the society. They don't find any representation. You have suicide.
Dr. Hina Gavit.
Exit is okay. Exit test is okay.